Davey Hamilton, Indy 500 veteran, promoter, crazy man. Davey Hamilton Jr., following his father's footsteps, not as crazy, a race driver recovering from his first bad crash of his career. We'll start with Dad. You know, you drive open wheel cars, you're going to crash. Sooner or later, you're going to go upside down. Sooner you're going to bust your butt. When you saw it happen, you were like, nah, that's going to be a tough one, or?
Yeah, it was big. You know when they're big. And when you hit left side, man, it just reminded me of Steele. You know, I mean, he hit that way, but a lot harder. So you don't know what the outcome's going to be. So it was very, very scary. What saved him was full containment seat. There's no question about it. I mean, the car was bent 18 inches over. The seat was actually almost outside the car. His elbow got in the wall. So the left rear was actually behind the seat. So, but what we're hearing, Carbon Kenny, and we have to have a seat. That was a full containment seat, but it was aluminum. It bent, it twisted in the car, which, like I say, he's here, he's standing, he's okay, he's got a concussion. So when you interview him, just know
well,
that.
He's a Hamilton.
Yeah.
He was born that way.
I've had a few. We all know that. Yeah. But you know, I think carbon seats is just a must in our kind of cars, and Kenny's made one that fits in sprint cars and midgets, and it's safety is most important.
Kid, did it knock you out, and what do you remember about it?
I don't know if I remember it, like, from the time being, but I know, like, when I was in the hospital, I watched the video over and over again, so it made me think I remember. I don't think I got knocked out, though. Not that I remember.
Yeah.
But the thing about it is, when you run, you know, the super modified you guys run, haul ass, especially on pavement, that's obviously where you race, but, I mean, that's a fast racetrack. Just you know immediately, it's going to be a big one?
Well, when the initial contact, I remember the initial contact whenever I got touched by somebody else.
You got hit from behind.
Yeah, and I knew as soon as when the car turned, I knew it was going to be a big hit, and I tried to kind of brace for it a little bit, but I knew it was pretty big, and once I hit the wall, I wanted to make sure I got out of the car as soon as possible, because when I see smoke or fire, I'm out of that car.
Right.
I mean, that's...
And it was hard probably getting out the way you were banged up.
Yeah, I thought my knee was broken. It hit the power steering pretty hard, so but I was lucky to get out of the car fast before the fire got bigger, and limped away for about 10 feet, but I'm glad I'm able to stand again and walk, so that's good.
Okay, the telltale sign for all these things, we've all been hurt in race cars. How fast can I get back in my car, Dad? Was that your first thought?
I think I was asking the doctor the day of to go racing at Kern County the next day or whatever, but I know it. You know, the it's important to get my head better, obviously, because I want to be racing again soon. I actually had a truck race next weekend in the Stadium Super Truck Series, but that's not going to happen.
No, just a few jumps in that. I think that might shake your head. That's probably a good one to pass on.
Yeah, I'm going to take a pass on that one. And you know, give all my will to Eric Davis. He's a guy that I drive for, so should be good.
So King of Wings is still going good, pretty good fields, pretty good competition. Davey, will the kid, the Indy Lights thing, you wanted to get him in that, is just so expensive. Where do you take it? What's his next step?
You know, that's a good question. The sprint car deals, I mean, that's what we were in. King and Wing had 32 cars at Irwindale, you know, palace of a racetrack. And, you know, what was fun is watching, you know, you're always proud of your kids and you want them to do well. And he's won championships and run races. But that particular one, when you're swapping the lead, I think they had 9 lead changes and 8 laps with him and Bobby Santos. So pretty cool to watch.
It was a hell of a pavement race.
Who can win, right? I mean, but future's hard. I mean, he wants to be in Indy Lights.
IndyCar eventually?
It would love to. I mean, that's really what he wants to do. It's just you have to have that lucky break. You have to have the financing to do it. It's not his talent. He won't go win every race this year, and that won't get him in the seat. It takes money to go along with it. So he's working extremely hard. Eric Davis, as he said, with Always Evolving, is working hard. I'm introducing him to all my past people, and we're just trying to raise enough money to keep him open wheel. He had some opportunity stock car racing. He still does. Not saying he's not going to do it, but he really has a passion for it.
But he's still a kid, so he's got time.
He's got time to wise up, right?
Rise up. All right, the Hamilton family, they're still standing and kicking ass. Thanks for watching Racer.com.